So typically, new materials, technologies, new batteries, new solar cells, these things take decades, tens of years. And LCD displays took almost 30 years to actually get into a product that could buy. We want to short circuit that. We want to take this new technology that's only a few years old and get it into impact much, much faster. But there's always the next stage. Next, after we do this, we replace silicon at 20%. There's how do you make 30% efficient cells? How do you make more efficient cells? How do you just go to the next generation of integration? We're talking about devices where we also integrate different functionality. So here's our energy harvester. We have a solar cell. We're talking about we need to make batteries to store the power. We need to have a display or a sensor to do something. Well, what if we print all those together? We manufacture all those in the same process. You know, this would be the first time you could ever do that kind of thing. So there's a whole lot of exciting, you know, technology development that builds on what we're doing. So, you know, we see this growing. We have a bigger term plan of this is initial facility. Correct me wrong, Dan. We're about seven point something million invested in this.
Yes.
But you know, we're talking about, you know, increasing that by tenfold to develop this into a major research facility.
Can you speak of the genesis of this new material that's better than silica?
Well, it really started with the concept of new materials that can be processed from solution as liquids, but turned into highly functional solar cell materials or battery materials. And people were looking, there was an approach to using like kind of what you think of when you think of flexible, you think plastics, you think organic materials. There's a lot of activity in that organic materials, plastics, as a way. But actually, one of the key innovations was actually a hybrid material. People were trying to make these cells better and had the idea of looking at a material which is a little outside of that plastics processing. And actually, it's a hybrid plastic and sort of metallic material, organic material. And that was sort of the magic. That was the sort of innovative step that sort of doubled the efficiency of the cells.
Does it have a name?
It's called perovskite, perovskite, organic, P-E-R-O-V-S-K-I-T-E. So perovskite is a Russian crystallographer. We call it hybrid perovskite because that means it's actually, perovskites are ceramics. We think of ceramics like oxides, like hard mineral type materials. The original structure, perovskite structure, was for a ceramic. This is unique in that part of the crystal, the atoms, part of it is like a traditional ceramic and part of it is actually an organic molecule. So it's a really unique, it's an old structure, but a really unique take on that old structure. And that particular combination is a way essentially to get properties that are like the hard stuff that takes thousands of degrees to make, you know, really good properties like, you know, silicon or other, you know, ceramic type materials, but with the solution processability of the organics that can be processed and AMC printed. And so that was really the kind of, you know, that's the real key of it. Maybe